If you don't know how I was raised, nigga, you wouldn't understand. Not at all. North Philly! Six of them.
I got a little beat or nothing. Turn something on for me right quick. Turn a beat on for me right quick.
You mean to tell me you about to blow this $1 million shot?
Nah.
You need to hear some music.
Yeah, I mean,
you're
I got
about
gotta
to blow this opportunity. It only come once in a lifetime. Or some music. You mean to tell me that's about to happen?
Nah,
that's what I'm witnessing.
Nah, bye, nah, bye. Hold on.
Yeah, I'm about to walk to the car. You don't want it.
Here you go.
Come on to the car. Come on, y'all.
Bars go hard. Walking with the knife tucked in my drawers. Gotta protect myself from the yard. Cause niggas walk around all day talking about. Hold on, talk. Damn, fuck, man. Y'all got me nervous, bro. Hold on. Damn.
You got me nervous.
All right. Real nigga right here.
Absolutely. Real niggas say you only get one shot, one block. I'ma let it pop, body drop. Nigga, I ain't playing, I ain't calling cops. Nigga switching around here, trying to get niggas knocked. You don't play that. Where I'm from, all the niggas bust gets. Roll stuff, get money, blow this and blow that. Yeah, trying to get on your track. Put me on something now. Gotta eat, man. Stomach hungry. You can hear it growl. Be what it is, yo.
Absolutely. Nigga straight from the gutter.
What's your name, my nigga? My name AB5.
AB?
Yeah.
AB5. You know what I mean? Y'all some real nigga, man.
Appreciate that, man.
Y'all can play them games, y'all know not to play with us.
Hey,
nigga, what you spending? They ain't spending much.
Them
niggas looking hungry, I can loan them couple bucks.
You know,
hey, nigga, what you driving? They ain't driving much. Last week I caught them niggas hopping on the bus. Hey, nigga, what you doing? They ain't doing much. They over there losing while them hoes choosing us. Got the power and respect, I'm so used to winning. Can't lie, addicted to money and women.
We about to get into this Gillie Da Kid interview, man. So what's good with you, man? What's been going on with you?
Working, man. You know what I'm saying? Just working. Got the album Welcome to Philadelphia coming out in end of October. Once I drop in Philadelphia, we'll no longer be known as Philadelphia.
Mm.
It turns into Philadelphia.
Philadelphia, so, right.
You know, that's a power statement right there.
I mean, it is what it is. You know, I'm the king of Philly for a reason. You know what I mean? I give out turkey on Thanksgiving, and I'm Muslim. Right?
That's what's up. Right. Listen, that's one thing I can definitely say about Philly is, like, some of the hottest MCs come out of Philly. Like, y'all definitely known for the lyricism. You know what I'm saying? Just for being ill rappers, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
You, Beans, Meek Mill.
I even go back to my younger, man. Shout out to my younger Meek Mill. So I got him on my CD. Me, him, and Yo Gotti got a record on my mixtape. So, you know, shout out to Meek Mill. Shout out to Yo Gotti. Two good dudes, you know what I mean?
Even going back to Will Smith, I had this debate with somebody the other day. I was like, yo, Will Smith, you know what I'm saying? That's the first rapper to win a Grammy. And
absolutely.
I promise you, them more sold more CDs than damn near anybody.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I mean, that's one, that's my, you know what I mean? That's what I look up to, like, when it comes to this, you know what I'm saying? Because I transitioned from the rapping to the acting. I got 3 movies on TV right now. So if you're home and you got Showtime, you can turn on Showtime, you can go on demand. You can pull them up on Netflix. You know what I mean? One of them is called Wrath of Kane, starring myself, Ving Rhames, Robert Patrick, Nipsey Hussle. Another one is called Mafia, starring myself, Ving Rhames, Pam Grier, the original Foxy Brown.
What is it like working with Pam Grier?
Oh man, Pam is wonderful, man. She's amazing. She's funny as ever.
That was the best celebrity show business answer ever. Yeah, you know, she's a really good person, man. She does great work, and I really enjoy it.
No, she really is. Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
To be her age, uh-huh. Absolutely.
That's right.
You know what I mean?
But, right now.
You know, no, she's really down to earth. You know what I'm saying? Like, really humble, you know what I'm saying? So, and she told me a lot of things while I was on set. So, you know what I mean? Just life things. So, shout out to Pam, you know what I mean? Robert Patrick. So, and I got another movie, King of the Avenue, starring myself, Ving Rhames, Esau Morales, and Simon Rex. So, I mean, I could keep going on about this movie.
Go with your boy Ving Rhames. I mean, he was in all 3 movies that you just named, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, well, I got a 10 movie deal with Ving. So that's, you know, he's gonna be in all of the movies that I was in, you know.
Yeah.
But he was filming a movie called Surrogates with Bruce Willis in Boston. and he had a couple days off. He went to like a little music storybook, some CDs and some DVDs. He popped a DVD, and it was an incident where a kid from my area named Cassidy had dissed me.
Okay.
Said something disrespectful, and I had went to his block. Mm. And Bing thought that was some gangster.
Right.
So he called up Black Child and was with Murder Inc.
Okay.
Asked Black Child, did he know me?
Right.
Black Child, like, yeah, I know Gillie. He gave him my number, and Bing called me and left me a message on the answer machine. And I ain't even call him back because I thought it was somebody.
They thought it was a joke, right?
Absolutely.
Right.
Then one of my homies listened to it. Said, man, you better call him back. I called him back, and it was 8 movies and a TV miniseries later. So, you know, God works in mysterious ways.
That's what's up.
Neither here or there. Cassidy is my homie now. We squashed that, so shout out to Cassidy. You know what I'm saying?
That's what's up, man. You know what I'm saying? I love that about other cities. Like, that's one of the things I be telling artists here in Charlotte. Like, a lot of reason why major labels don't even want to come here is because our artists, they don't want to collaborate. It's like, you know what I'm saying? We're not even owned yet, and we're trying to make it. And, like, there's no reason for promoters within a city and artists within a city to have beef, especially if you're not a national artist. Like, you haven't even made it yet. Right. You know what I'm saying? There's no reason for you to be beefing with the dude from the west side. Why? Like, you know what I'm saying? What are you beefing about? You know what I'm saying?
I try to talk to the kids, and you know what I mean? I got a gang prevention program that I do with myself, Ving Rhames, Big U, head of the Rolling 60 Crips out in Cali. You know what I'm saying? So we fly all over the world, St. Thomas, St. Croix, Dominican Republic, you know what I'm saying? All over just doing gang prevention stuff, you know what I mean?
So let me ask you this. I mean, you know, because we talk about it all the time. Like, one, you know, because we broadcast in Chicago, you know what I'm saying, too, because y'all show broadcast in Chicago in the morning. You know what I'm saying? And we hear so many stories about, you know, just what's going on in the neighborhoods. You know what I'm saying? Like, especially in Chicago, you know, that's like the murder capital right now. Like, you know, more people have died in Chicago in the past 5 years than in the war in Iraq and Afghanistan. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, what do you think the cause of the tension in the hood, or, you know what I'm saying, the things that's going on, and, like, what do you think we can do to really try to bring ourselves out of that situation? Do you think that the music that's out right now, the entertainment business out right now, is influencing it, or?
The music ain't got nothing to do with it, you know what I mean? Because, you know, like my son listens to whatever he wants. He gets all of these and these, you know what I'm saying? So it's really about the parenting,
right?
You know what I'm saying? It's just, where I come from, you don't have a single parent. You ain't even no rap. You ain't got your mom or your dad. That's like, what? That's what I heard of. You feel what I'm saying? And we were 6 of us in a 2-bedroom apartment, so we be sleeping on top of each other.
Right? I know what that's like.
You feel what I'm saying? So, it's like, then you always got something to prove. You know what I'm saying? For me, I was a little dude, and I ain't had no big brothers I could run to. So
right.
It's like, oh, you gonna play with me? Okay, now I'ma take it to the extreme.
Right.
So that next time, it ain't gonna cross your mind to play with me. You feel what I'm saying? So it was like, okay, then I go to that extreme, then it's like, but at the same time, my name getting bigger, so I'm like, oh,
right,
this is what I gotta do.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Right now, I'm gonna go to double that extreme. Mm. Now my name getting bigger. Oh,
right.
Man, I'm feeling myself. Oh, man, where they at? What they say what?
So let me ask, because I agree with you.
So that's how it is in the hood.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? Once you get that juice, see, now I look at life, it's crazy, brother.
You just made that statement.
Right. It's crazy, right? Because I get a high off of being on set.
Okay.
You feel what I'm saying? I get a high off of being on stage. I get a high off of being on trips with my kids. You feel what I'm saying?
Right.
Seeing them go on planes and enjoying it. And
right.
Taking boat trips. And I used to get a high off of being known really as a taker. Like, that was my high life.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? So when you at a different level, your highs really be lows.
Right.
Wow. You feel what I'm saying? Where you come from, where I come from.
Well, because I say that all the time, because I agree with you. You're like, you know what I'm saying, our age, you know what I'm saying, people our age, we grew up listening to Eazy-E, Snoop Dogg,
absolutely,
Wu-Tang Clan, and the music wasn't the influence. You know what I'm saying? It's not necessarily the music, because I'm not looking at Eazy-E and be like, yeah, I want to be like that, necessarily. You know what I'm saying? But I'm looking more around what's going on with my surroundings.
Right.
And saying, I want to be like that. So, when you look at it that way, you know what I'm saying, why do you think it is that we seem to cling to negative images? Like, you know, you have us, we cling to, we'll celebrate the dude who just did 35 in prison for not snitching, But we won't celebrate the kid who just, you know what I'm saying, graduated from engineering school, MIT. Mm. You know what I'm saying? He won't get the same celebration coming back to the hood.
I mean, you know, for me, I don't know. I think that's just the media. The media loves negativity. You look at all the TV shows, you ain't on there unless you ratchet.
That's true. You got to be ratchet. Shout out to Jocelyn.
You know what I mean? I just, to be all the way honest, you know, I just was getting golfers to sit down to be on Love and Hip Hop.
Okay.
You feel me? But I'm good. You feel what I'm saying?
So what made you choose not to go that route?
That's just not me. You right. know what I'm saying? That's not for me.
Right.
You feel me? Me being placed in a setting where I got to talk to some people that I really don't get down with.
Right.
And they ain't going to be their true self. So they going to say something that's off, that's right. totally out of line to try to get some ratings. Right. To try to, and then it's going to be a whole different issue on that
situation.
Set. So right. we ain't even going to put my, I ain't going to even place myself in that situation.
Some rest.
I do this.
You see how this nigga sweet?
Wow. Yo, hey, you wanna go there? Deniro, you want this body
sweet.
Shot?
Ice sleep.
Ice sleep. I'm like, damn, you know we had the double job. We got the double bed, you know. I'm small, I'm a little nigga, so I'm like, listen, man, you know, just give me a couple pillows. Let me take the top blanket. All right, go ahead, you know what I mean?
I don't need no bed.
Hit the floor, like where he had the other bed or whatever. Nigga said, nah, I don't sleep in beds. I said, what? That nigga said, I sleep like this. Why? I thought he was bullshit. When I came back to the club, that nigga went to the bathroom, freshened up, came back out. Like, oh, I'm all that y'all tomorrow. Straight to sleep. I said, damn!
That's that on duty shit.
Sleep.
The hair, right? Yeah.
No. That came from me 20 years doing this shit. Whereas I used to come home like 4 in the morning, my wife be asleep. So I would go on the knee and talk to her. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it just became a habit. I never got back up.
Yeah.
You talk to her and fall asleep with her.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So you wake up on your knees, like, fuck it. So now, like when I get desperate, if we gotta make a hurry and I need a quick nap real fast, I'm right to the knee, I fall asleep fast. I get in the bed, toss, turn, nut shit, bed too soft. No, fuck that. I know if I gotta get to sleep and we gotta hurry up and do something, right to the knee. How fast I go to sleep?
2.5 fucking seconds.
Rapper story came up with both parents, they was clapping for me. High school graduate.